On the workbench tonight, I have a piece of equipment that was banned by the Federal Communications Commission in 1987. Can you guess which one it is? No, it's not this Panasonic TV. It's not these two Sony VHS VCRs. Nor is it this Sony Digital 8 Handycam. Instead, it is this Archer Multiple Video Distribution System. Its purpose is to take video from three different sources and rebroadcast it onto three UHF TV channels so that you can watch all three sources on one TV without needing to swap any cables around. For example, I have one VCR playing on channel 74, another VCR playing on channel 78, and the Handycam playing on channel 82. If you've never heard of channels that high ever being used, you're not alone, because they were actually reallocated by the FCC to what they called land mobile radio service all the way back in 1970. However, it was allowed to coexist with low power UHF TV translators, which are transmitters which take the signal of one station on one channel and rebroadcast it on another channel in order to add to its coverage. Those low power UHF TV translators were allowed to occupy the channels between 70 and 83. However, those were shared with cell phone service. But beginning in 1987, the FCC decided to also allocate part of those frequencies for use by what they called public safety. In other words, police departments, fire departments, rescue squads, and the like. So in the late 1980s, you saw TVs going from being able to tune all the way up to channel 83 on UHF to now no longer being able to tune any higher than channel 69. On UHF due to that FCC decision. As a result, Radio Shack was forced to take this product, which they had only just introduced in 1985, off the market until they were able to redesign it to only use channels 69 and below. And that's exactly what they did. They introduced a new version, and on the box they advertised works with all 69 channel TV tuners. Nonetheless, despite the FCC banning it 35 years ago, I still have one of these older versions that uses those upper UHF channels above 69, and it still works fine. Here's a closer look at the now forbidden Archer Multiple Video Distribution System. This is a nice metal silver box. On the back, you can see all the inputs and outputs. The first input is just a pass-through from your antenna or cable system, so whatever is coming into this will be passed through to the outputs. But then it has three auxiliary inputs, which accept any video source broadcasting on channel 3. So for example, the output of a VCR or a satellite TV tuner or a video game, you can connect those to these three inputs. It needs to be channel 3, it doesn't work with channel 4. But instead of just being passed through to the output, which wouldn't make any sense because they're all on channel 3, and if you try to combine them together, they would interfere with each other. Instead, the AUX 1 input is rebroadcast on UHF channel 74. The AUX 2 input is rebroadcast on channel 78. And the AUX 3 input is rebroadcast on channel 82. And you have three outputs, so you can actually connect three different TVs to this. So that was part of its purpose. You could have multiple TVs in the house, all sharing one VCR, one cable TV box, and one satellite TV tuner or anything else you want to have connected. Just the downside is that all three users would need to agree on which channel to leave the cable box set to, because they wouldn't be able to independently control it. And that redesigned version, which used channels 69 and below, due to the FCC no longer allowing these high UHF channels from being used, only had two AUX inputs besides the pass-through. It had one RF input for channel 3 and one composite video input with audio jacks. So during the redesign, it lost one of the inputs, I guess because it was more likely that the channels 69 and below would be actually used by local TV stations in your area, whereas these upper UHF channels were very unlikely to be used for anything in your area, so it was almost guaranteed you wouldn't have any problems with interference. Here's the sticker on the bottom indicating it was made in Taiwan, and this is the Radio Shack date code indicating it was made in October 1985. Also on the bottom, it has three thumb wheels for fine-tuning those three inputs. Here's a look inside, and it's probably not as exciting as you had hoped, because besides the power supply, most of what you can see are these shielded metal boxes, because these are all on channel 3, and if they were allowed to radiate out any of the signal, it would interfere with the neighboring ones. So that's why they're all in these shielded metal boxes, to keep that cross interference from happening. And then on the circuit board on the bottom is where all the magic happens, where it takes those inputs and rebroadcasts them on the upper UHF channels. And those are very sensitive coils there. If I touched them, it would upset the tuning calibration of this, so I'm not even going to try to take these out to get a better look at that. It's working fine, so I'm just going to leave it alone and put the cover back on. And because, as its name suggests, this was designed to be a video distribution system, I think its output power is quite a bit higher than the RF modulators built into most VCRs and other devices like that. I'm getting a very strong and clear image with almost no noticeable interference. Now, like I mentioned, any TV made since the late 1980s can no longer tune these upper UHF channels, but I do have one VCR from 1985 which does tune up to channel 83 on UHF, and I'm feeding its video and audio output into my modern LCD TV. So now I have it tuned to one of these VCRs on channel 74.
Possibly. Okay. I prepared a little sketch here of the situation.
Then a channel 78 is the other VCR.
Well, Callie, this is the key to using Jetta's central power locking system.
Then on 82 is the Handycam. And I guess that was the end of the tape we just saw. Now I'm going to give you some direct hookup video samples of the radar tape on channel 74, the VW Jetta tape on channel 78, and the Digital 8 Handycam tape on channel 82.
More than anything, it depends on how well you prepare yourself. If you've done your homework and make a neat and respectful appearance, most judges are willing to listen to your case. Some will go out of their way to make allowances for your inexperience. Judges aren't ogres, but their time is valuable. Don't waste it by coming unprepared. You don't have to be a Clarence Darrow or even Perry Mason to present an effective defense.
Now, central locking system also has a selective lock unlock feature. To unlock a single front door, just turn the key to the left once. Two turns of the key in rapid succession unlocks all of the doors. Now turn it to the left and hold it until all of the windows are lowered to the desired position. By the way, this works for all windows. This convenience open feature will help cool off the inside of your Jetta when it's been sitting in the hot sun for a while.
By the way, if you're wondering how I'm able to get an RF output from a camcorder, that's because one of these things, a Sony RFU adapter, which plugs into the audio and video outputs, and there's an extra connector there which provides power to the RF modulator through this center pin here. So you plug it in to the camcorder, you get a switch between channel 3 and channel 4, and then you plug this into your TV or VCR. So that's been a look at the Archer multiple video distribution system, which was banned by the FCC because it used upper UHF channels which were reallocated for mobile phones and public safety service in the late 1980s. But if you have one of these, it's an interesting way to make use of these otherwise unused upper UHF channels, which you'll need something from the 1980s or older to actually be able to tune. And no, it's not compatible with cable TV tuners, which go above channel 69, because those use different frequencies. So if I had one of these at the time, I would have been very happy with it, despite the FCC banning it, because it allowed me to connect three different video sources, plus the pass-through from the antenna, and view them on three upper UHF TV channels on my TV.
Thank you.